back option very soon now. Are you getting the EBU caption? I shall be starting the commentary very shortly, London, if you're rolling. I'll probably start when the two teams come. With lots of pauses for you. Well, the massive stadium here, the Olympic Stadium, built for the 1928 Olympics, and a crowd of 65,000 here awaiting the arrival of the two teams. Six and a half thousand of that 65,000 crowd are Nottingham Forest fans. Well, the Ajax side, top of the Dutch league, but a team that lost here 6-3 in the league on Sunday. They've dropped one of the local favourites, the winger Simon Tahamata, and replaced him with Carol Bonsink. Three Danes in the side, Lerbe, Jensen and Arneson, but the best known player is the defender Ruud Krol. The Nottingham Forest side, one change, Ian Bowyer gets the number 8 shirt with Stan Bowles moving down to substitute, but Forest pinning so many of their hopes tonight on the ability of Francis and Bertels to show a lot of pace up front and to get the vital away goal that would just about seal a victory for the Forest. And here are the sides with Ajax in their red shirts with white sleeves on the left of the picture as we look at them now. Nottingham Forest tonight playing in an all-yellow strip. Ajax, 18 times the champions of Holland and three times the winners of the European Cup in 1971, 72 and 73. But much more concerned at the moment about that amazing 6-3 defeat here against a lowly side, Maastricht, in the Dutch League on Sunday. Forest with a lot of confidence about them, which has been easy to detect in the last couple of days, but one would hope confidence but not complacency. All the officials tonight are from Romania, the referee Nicolae Rainea. And behind that posse of photographers, the two captains, Rudy Kroll of Ajax and John McGovern of Nottingham Forest. The referee tonight is Nicolae Rainea from Romania, with two Romanian linesmen, of course. So away we go then, Nottingham Forest in the yellow strip attacking the goal to our left on a night when nerve will play almost as big a part as skill and character, as Forest seek to preserve this two-goal lead they won so well in the first leg at Nottingham. McGovern quickly in on the action there. Forest determined that they will come here and attack, as Peter Taylor has told you. But they are now conceding a free kick within the first seconds of the game, halfway inside their own half. Ajax top of the Dutch League at the moment by 2 points. And they've not lost a European Cup tie here since 1969. And Forest, well, they might so easily have conceded a penalty there as Bonsink tried to wing his way through. This is Lairby playing it forward again, onside. This time Bonsink is there, wanting to pull it back, and pulling it back only for Boyer to whack it away. Into touch, but an early scare there for Nottingham Forest. Now Kroll. Being closely shadowed there by Trevor Francis, that's too firm, and it's behind for the goal kick. The prize, of course, is an enormous one. A real money spinner in Madrid on May the 28th, the European Cup final. Peter Shilton with a kick for Forest. And the noise is absolutely deafening. Kroll again in there for Ajax. The number three here, Mutsteger, back to Piet Schrijvers, the Dutch international goalkeeper. Weinberg, the number four. The man who marked John Robertson in the first leg, Laling, who's got that left knee very heavily strapped. Weinberg back again. Some amazing scoring by Ajax in the earlier rounds. They beat Helsinki on an aggregate of 16-2 and Armenia Nicosia of Cyprus 10-4, and then beat Strasbourg, the French champions, on an aggregate of 4-0, having beaten them on this ground 4-0. They are really a formidable proposition here as Kroll tries to make something work again, but it's Kenny Burns this time getting it away. The number 11, Schoenacker, Kroll again, played wide this time towards Lerby. Going a long way until he tangles there with Larry Lloyd. Jensen. And Arneson. And an offside on this occasion, giving a free kick. Certainly brave words on the part of the Forest management that they're coming here to attack, but I think it's realistic to expect that they'll have to do an awful lot of defending here tonight against a very skillful side. Kroll ducking in with the header again. Lerby once more, but cut out by Anderson for Nottingham Forest. The number 7, Jensen. Kroll, who loves to come forward, and Forrest must really watch that. Here's Laling, the number 9. Stopped that time, though, by Frankie Gray. Supported here by Robertson. And played forward now for Francis. A throw to Forrest. Bertels. And that's a corner. No goal kick. Goal kick. Well, that's unbelievable. Well, that's an aberration by the Romanian referee without any question. That was clearly a corner. Lutsteger. Bonsink, and a throw to Ajax. Lerby, one of the Danes, to Jensen, another one, but cut out that time by Larry Lloyd, and an enormous belt there by Kroll. Played in two World Cups, 74 and 78, and indeed played in those three European Cup finals that Ajax won at the start of the decade. So Peter Shilton with the kick for Nottingham Forest. Francis shoved off the ball there a little bit by Berver. But here's Francis again. Bertels up there with him, brought down, free kick. Francis gingerly goes forward into that penalty area. It's going to be Kenny Burns. Larry Lloyd's gone up again for Nottingham Forest. Played wide here for John Robertson. Weinberg, who marked him at Nottingham, and he's brought him down. Another free kick to Nottingham Forest. Now Lloyd has stayed up. Francis on the far side there. Ian Bowyer's in there too. Here's Bertels coming towards this one as well. Looking for a yard, but denied it. That's another throw now to Nottingham Forest. Francis coming quickly there off his man. Oh, and a nice bit of skill there. And the cross that comes in as well, but Lerb is there getting it away for Ajax. McGovern turning it back again, and a linesman with his flag up. That was a real hairline decision. And Martin O'Neill's being called to the Romanian referee, who wasn't happy that he carried on with the play after the whistle had gone. So now it's Kroll for Ajax. Bonsink to Mutsteger. Kenny Burns away for an Ajax throw. McGovern trying to release men forward, but Bertels looked a little slow there. On sink again. Coming this way towards Mertsteger. Lalling supporting him here on the touchline, but the ball's out of play. A throw to Forrest. Robertson with the throw. Francis, ooh, caught something in the face there from Weinberg. A free kick to Forrest. A game of stops and starts at the moment. But the tension out there must be quite extraordinary. Robertson playing it in. Here's Bertels. Back again, this time for Frankie Gray. Well, Francis getting free, whipping one in across there. A little too high for Martin O'Neill. But he's getting support here from McGovern. And a throw to Ajax. Henning Jensen with it. Anderson played in for McGovern. Trying to get Anderson again on his way. Burns in quickly, and again a saving challenge there. Lerby a little lucky there. He was looking the wrong way when the throw was taken. Here's Bonsink, beaten though by Boya. And now McGovern. O'Neill playing it back for Kenny Burns. Anderson, a nice little touch there for McGovern. O'Neill again, nicely round Lerby. But stopped by Berber. Now Lerby, and Burns away. Francis looking for a free kick there, and a foul there by Viv Anderson. A free kick to Ajax. Jensen the victim. Kroll. Mutsteger just managed to keep it in. Gray going in hard. Boya, the little touch here for John Robertson. And a Forrest throw. Yeah, Forrest getting a free kick. Frank Gray. High towards Trevor Francis. But Ajax know all about the problems that he can pose. Scored one of the goals, of course, and made the second in effect in the first leg to Francis. Lalling, a nice little touch there. To the number 11, Schoenacker. Bonsink, back to Kroll. Played to Berver on the far side. Lerbe supporting him. This is the fullback Berver. Forward for Kroll again. And this time Anderson is there. And a throw to Ajax. Berver with it. Played out. Forrest throw, Viv Anderson. McGovern did not quite the pace enough. He looked to have had that ball, and this should be Frankie Gray's, but here's Laling coming in, crossing it in again. Larry Lloyd just getting there well for Nottingham Forest. That was a very important header that he got in there. Bonsink again, crowded out, and Laling won't stop that one, going out of play for a throw to Nottingham Forest. So the Ajax players and their crowd believe it should be theirs. Just over 12 minutes gone, no score. Forest with that 2-0 lead from the first leg. Mertesacker beaten by Robertson, and another free kick to Nottingham Forest. And the referee is really very sharp indeed. Laling showed the slightest bit of dissent there, and he was almost feeling for a yellow card. Well, that should be a warning for all of them. Francis chesting it down there for Boyer. Boyer trying, or rather Bertels, trying to get it back again for Francis. And now it's with Rudy Kroll. Swept wide to Berger. Kroll. McGovern quickly coming in to close him down, which he needs to do. And here are Forrest now. And certainly when Kroll goes forward, he leaves the back a little bit depleted. Only two stay back. Arneson playing it to Lerby, and well, Schoenacker was right in there, and the linesman in fact had a flag up. It caused a buzz around the ground, but there was no doubt about Dick Schoenacker being offside. Kenny Burns with a header. Schoenacker. Lerby. It's with Kroll. Oh, almost cut out there by Bertels. That could have been dangerous for Ajax. Instead of that, it's Weinberg now letting Laling take possession. Mertesacker. Lerby. Jensen finding Kroll. Played inside for Weinberg. Lerby again. Bonsink. And a nice interception there by Bowyer for Nottingham Forest. Bertels playing it back for Frankie Gray, and in turn it'll go back to Peter Shulman. We thought Forrest would have to do a lot of defending, and the slightly disturbing thing about it at the moment is that there's not a lot of sparkle coming up front from Bertels and Francis as yet. McGovern battling away in the midfield though, and now O'Neill. Anderson on the far side. Still in possession, Viv Anderson, looking to get his cross in, but supported here by Martin O'Neill, in turn supported by McGovern. And it's back with Pete Shrivers. Lerby, the long ball forward. Schoenacker's after it, but there's Shilton. Might well go back again. Robertson with a header. Kroll coming in there. McGovern with another header. O'Neill trying to get between Lerby and the goal, but it's back with Shrivers. And now Rudy Kroll. Lerby.
Berver. Weinberg. The Dane, Lerby again to Rudy Kroll. Bertel's going across there to try and prevent the run coming forward. And again, a good interception by Forrest, this time by Bowyer, and Francis fractionally offside. So a free kick to Ajax. Weinberg, Lulling. Player of Chinese extraction, but born in Holland, and in fact has played for Holland. Oh, a nice little dummy there by Kroll for Lerby, who mishit that pass, and Anderson was there, and Francis was brought down by Berver, and a yellow card for the number two of Ajax, Peter Berver, for the foul on Trevor Francis. Trevor Francis getting rather gingerly to his feet. I noticed that the referee wouldn't allow Jimmy Gordon on to attend to him. It's Kenny Burns with a free kick for Nottingham Forest. Martin O'Neill. Anderson making a galloping run there for the Forest. In for O'Neill again. Anderson, and now O'Neill, can he get the ball into the middle? It's now with, well, it bounced away from Trevor Francis, and now here's Ajax making the break with the number 10, Bonsing, and on the far side, Arneson, the Dane, couldn't quite take control of it. Little cross coming in there, and Lloyd, I thought for a moment, was going to get in the way of Peter Shilton. And they're having quite a conversation there that could easily have skimmed off the turf that's had a bit of rain on it. But Shilton was nicely behind it. Forrest were banking so much on the ability of their midfield men like O'Neill and Robertson to come and support Francis and Bertels, and they've not really had a chance to do that yet. Jensen finding Lulling. Arneson, but it's cut out again. Lulling again, this time for the number 8, Arneson. And now Mertzdecker, the little cross coming in, but going off Larry Lloyd for the corner for Ajax. Twenty minutes gone, no score. Arneson with the corner, floated in short there. Kenny Burns getting up well for Forrest. McGovern helping it on its way. Arneson again, played in once more, Forrest there. This time it was McGovern. And eventually Robertson putting it away into touch. Good break here, Arneson again for Ajax, coming up on the far side. Well, it was Lerby, and now it's Bonsink, but they're crowding him out, those yellow shirts. In the end, it's Mertzdecker hitting it against Frankie Gray. Robertson getting it away. Mertzdecker, the defender again. Lulling. Good little spell this for Ajax, and they've pulled a lot of people forward. Kroll is right in there too, but this time O'Neill, even at the expense of a throw, gives Forrest that little bit of a breather. But not for long. Bonsink again. Anderson picking his way out of trouble there, but it's another throw. Arneson in a lot of space on the edge of that Forrest penalty area, but Kenny Burns got the header in. Lerby. Kroll. And how quickly Bertels is in there. It's clearly one of the jobs these front men have got to do for Forrest. Every time Kroll's anywhere near the ball, they've got to be closing him down very quickly. Good header by Lloyd towards Bertels. Clashing there with Kroll again. But you can see how tigerish Bertels was there, but Kroll nonetheless found Lallin. With Schoenacher going outside him, but the corner goes to Ajax. So Arnesen again with Larling at the near post. Lurby right in there too. Floating a little one in towards that near post again. Looking for the back flick with the header. But Burns was there to put it away for another corner. A little bit of pressure on Forrest now. Halfway through the first half. Still no score in this leg. And Forrest leading by 2-0 from the first leg. But needing to withstand this pressure as Arnesen takes another corner for Ajax. A deeper one this time towards Lurby on the far side. Got his header in well, but Shilton gathered it well under pressure from Schoenacher. And in fact, there was a foul on the Nottingham Forest keeper. So far, so good then for Nottingham Forest. Foul by Boyer given, almost on the centre line, another free kick for Ajax. Lulling. Boyer right there with him. Mustegger. Weinberg. Schoenacher. Well, that might come for Bertels, or indeed it'll come for Francis, which is just as good. Support coming up quickly from the yellow shirts. It's Martin O'Neill, Francis away on the far side. Played back this time to Viv Anderson. Francis once more. Looking for the yard, almost getting it through to Boyer. There was a handball, I think, by Boyer, yes, and a free kick to Ajax. Henning Jensen now for Ajax. Berver away on the far side. A throw to Ajax. Lurby. Arnesen. Berver. A space there for him to get that cross in. Lloyd is up there well though, and Robertson feeling that that was the safest way out, even at the expense of a corner, just ducking in there with his header. And again a corner for Ajax, this time to be taken by Lalling. A more powerfully struck one there towards Lurby, played here for Mustegger and played through an offside. A really good break there by Henning Jensen, but caught just that yard offside. Forrest at the moment still not getting very much together up front. Weinberg, Berver on this side again, keeps switching from one side of the field to the other. Boyer coming in hard there, but not getting possession from the number seven, Jensen. Here he is again. A little touch through here for Kroll. And a lovely ball played by Kroll for Lalling. Oh, and he's turned Frankie Gray well, but Gray was back there recovering, and Shilton was out there with a fist. And that's a throw to Ajax. Rudy Kroll with it. Back for Kroll again from Bonsink. The long cross is going Shilton's way. And it's almost one against one there when Kroll goes forward again. Bertels and Francis up there, and there's just... Well, if Francis could have got the better of Berver, then that might have been very interesting. Now it's with Bertels. Arnesen back there for Ajax. Kroll. Lerbe. Terrific goal-scoring record, Lerbe. 9 in the European Cup so far this season. Although that was mostly done against the Finns and the Cypriots in the first two rounds. Kroll playing it on again for Jensen. Two really experienced campaigners, those two, as Jensen takes it up again from Kroll. And Forrest having trouble getting this away. Robertson couldn't get it away, and they've conceded another corner. As Bonsing tried to get in there, it came off Frankie Gray. And Laling again to take it. Another long, long, deep one. Lloyd getting the header in. Arnesen playing it back to Weinberg. Kroll wanting it, though, sensing that Ajax are having a good little spell here. It's with Lerby again, trying a long shot, but that's no problem at all. It's a goal kick for Forrest. Putting a lot of pressure on Forrest, Ajax, without really creating chances at the moment. That's been their problems over the last few weeks, and that's why they brought in Bonsink at the expense of Taha Mata, who's such a local favourite. Kroll again for Ajax. Cut out by Frankie Gray. Mertesteeger. Kroll. Sweeping it to the far side to Lerby. Back this time to Berva. Arnesen looked like handball there, but the referee thought otherwise. Weinberg. Laling. Played on again for Weinberg, who'd made the run forward, but Kenny Burns was there. Not at all happy with the way that he was challenged by Weinberg. A throw to Ajax. That was not very good marking there, because Bonsink very nearly was able to get a shot in across the face of that goal. It's a corner, though, for Ajax. Forrest just a little slow to react to that throw. And Arnesen with another corner for Ajax, who are having a really good spell now. Laling, ball played in very low there. A chance maybe to cross it now. No, he plays it instead to Bonsink. Surely crowded out by those yellow shirts of Forrest. And another throw to Ajax. And Forrest at the moment really under the whip. It's with Rudy Kroll. Bertels really tangling with him again. He's come back to do a good job, and in fact he stopped the ball going in there. Although it's another corner to the Dutchman. Half an hour gone. No score. Forrest still leading 2-0 from the first leg. Arnesen with the corner for Ajax. Played in there again. And Kroll finding the ball coming to him. But that must have gone off a Forrest defender, because it's another corner on the far side this time. At least the referee was pointing to the far side. Forrest are taking it from this side. Again with Frank Arnesen. Again hit in low. McGovern with the header. Not getting it away very well. Robertson challenging hard. Another throw to Ajax. And Forrest have hardly been out of their own half for the last 5 minutes. It's, well, Bonsink optimistically put the ball down for a free kick. It's a throw. And there's a bit of space here for Arnesen turning it in again, but McGovern there towards Trevor Francis. And that's going to be another Forrest throw, but certainly at least a little deeper, and indeed even inside the Ajax half. Arnesen for Ajax. Schoenacker. Laling. Well, a chance maybe for a break. Well, beautifully kept in play there by Berva, and Frank Gray needing to get back quickly. Robertson there now, playing it forward again. Francis checked bodily, it seemed to me, there by Mertesteeger. And Berve taking possession again for Ajax. Kroll. Lurby on the far side. And now a throw for Forrest. Bertels played for Anderson. Here's McGovern for Anderson again. And an offside against Martin O'Neill. Soren Lurby now for Ajax. Peter Berver to Rudy Kroll. Certainly the job of Francis and Bertels not to allow him to make any progress there. It was Francis who was making the challenge there, and it was a pretty wild kick by Frankie Gray. Berver, but so far Forrest are holding. They certainly haven't been able to adopt the policy that Peter Taylor was talking about at the start of the night, coming here to be positive and to attack, because Ajax have been just a little too good for that. Quite a different proposition than the side that they showed themselves to be in the first leg. It's a lot more heart about them than I think people suspected. And Boya getting there took a shove in the back, surely. Well, it's either a goal kick or a free kick. Peter Shilton with the kick. Shinaka, challenged by Boya and by O'Neill. Shinaka again, challenged this time by Viv Anderson. Shielded that well. Kroll trying to play it again into those forward areas. But Bertels is almost doing a marking job on him now. And the long ball forward this time from Viv Anderson towards Trevor Francis. Playing well again. Here's Bertels. That's gone behind Robertson. But there's support for him now from Frankie Gray. He's gone outside him. And here's Gray now. Can he whip the cross in? He can, but there's nobody there quite to finish it off. And it's back with Pete Shrivers, who's had almost a spectator's role. Now Schoenacker, this might be dangerous against Forrest. O'Neill's come back, Anderson's back there as well. Here's Arneson. O'Neill, good marking job again. Anderson, and now McGovern taking it from Francis, trying to get Bertels on his way. 10 minutes to go to half-time. Weinberg to Henning Jensen, to Rudy Kroll. Jensen again. Jensen played it this time for Dick Schoenacker. He thought about a shot, the crowd wanted him to take it, but he's found Soren Lurby instead, supported by Kroll. Rudy Kroll now. Lurby. Well, they got in a bit of a muddle there, but Boya's pass out really is only providing a breather. Here's Weinberg. Lalling. Looks as though Robertson was almost held off there by the man's arms, and here's Trevor Francis. Showing a bit of pace, Lurby's after him, free kick, and that might even be a yellow card. But it's not. It was a desperate challenge by the Dane, Lurby, on Trevor Francis, who for the first time in the night was really in full flight. It's with Robertson, the little pass from Boya. And getting it across there for Pete Shrivers to take at the near post. Ajax setting up another attack. And it was Jensen making a long, long run there. Bonsink now. And in fact, it was Arnesen brought down there right on the edge of the penalty area. Now, this might be a problem for Forest. Kroll will come up to mastermind it. Lerby is there too. Forest are putting a number of men into the wall. Lerby might well make just the little shot there, a little pass for Arnesen. In fact, it was quite easily charged down, Jensen's shot. And now O'Neill, oh, obstructed there, blatantly. And it's certainly a free kick. And whether the ref has got a yellow card out, as you can see, on Mersteger, the number three. Well, that's the second yellow card for Ajax. First to Berva and then to Mersteger. And it'll be a free kick to Forest as we come towards the last 7 minutes of the first half. Well, that's adding almost insult to injury, because Mersteger, in checking Martin O'Neill, has done himself no good and has gone inside no good by getting a yellow card. Berve playing it back, and Shrivers needing to dive there at the feet of Gary Birtles. Jensen. Lerby, the long ball forward, and that's no problem for Peter Shilton. Ajax coming forward again, Jensen, but Arnesen stopped by the challenge of Kenny Burns. Kroll, the long ball forward again. Lalling, a lovely ball by Kroll. One of the great old Ajax side of the early 1970s. Lalling getting the ball in there again, and Larry Lloyd caught it in the face. Although I think the Ajax people felt that it hit him on the arm as well, and I must say that's the impression I got. But Lloyd very quickly clutched his head, and maybe the linesman and referee were convinced as well. But it's Arnesen with a corner for Ajax. Floating in again towards the near post, Kenny Burns up very well indeed that time for Nottingham Forest. And in came Robertson, quite content to give away another corner. So often floating these corners in towards the near post, but that's a much, much deeper one towards Lerby, but it'll not get to him. It was Martin O'Neill who got the header in there for Forest, who will be desperate to make at least an initial breakthrough before half-time. And they have less than 5 minutes now to do that. Berve with Francis, and a throw going to Ajax. Lerby again. Weinberg. Kroll again. You can see they're saying, let me have it and see what we can do. Well, he's found Lalling. Now it's Arnesen. Kroll had gone forward as well, and Birtles had gone right there with him. Arnesen playing it wide again to Lerbe. So Lerbe for Ajax. A long shot. Oh! Calling for a good save as that ball bounced awkwardly in front of Peter Shilton. Well, he let swing there when there really looked to be no danger. And Shilton had to really make sure he got behind that one. Anyone? Dick Schoenacker. Lalling. Berver. Kroll. Again, sweeping out those beautiful passes, but that time it was just a little too powerful. And Lerbe couldn't keep it in play. Anderson with the throw for Nottingham Forest. And away go Forest again with Gary Birtles. Robertson's getting into the middle there, and deflection off an Ajax defender, and the bounce coming conveniently there for Pete Shrivers. Lalling. But they've made one or two little mistakes, Ajax, in the last 10 minutes, and Forest on these breakaways might well be able to produce something from them. But at the moment, it's Ajax again coming forward with Kroll. Lalling. Schoenacker. Played for Lerby. And Arneson on the far side. And a goal kick given. Looked like a kick in the face for Boya. Francis. Played on this time by Robertson for Trevor Francis again. And he couldn't quite keep it in play. It's a goal kick. Coming into the last minute of the first half. Shriver's urging Kroll to go forward. He needs no urging. That's a long ball forward and it's too firm again. Here, quite a number of the 6,500 Nottingham Forest fans beginning to find their voices now as Anderson takes it up and plays it back again to Peter Shilton. A good solid first half by Nottingham Forest. It's by no means been an extravaganza because Ajax, who've had so much more of the play, have been unable to finish, and Forest have been too busy defending to be able to set up too many attacks of their own. But in terms of a winning performance, it really is so far so good for Forest, preserving this two-goal lead. And the half-time whistle goes from the Romanian referee, and Ajax still have a lot to do, still with this two-goal deficit, still worried about people like Trevor Francis and the pace and the threat that they have coming forward, although it's been in defence more than anything else that Forest have looked so secure during this first half. Not spectacular, but really so far so good so far as English football is concerned. A half-time score then here in the Olympic Stadium in Amsterdam, the semi-final second leg of this European Cup. It's Ajax 0, Nottingham Forest 0, and we'll be back with the second half.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a message for the Nottingham Forest fans. For fans, go by plane, but first by train to Schiphol. They have to take the following route. When you go out of the stadium, turn right. Before which, turn left. And then, by the light, again to the right. Then over the bridge, and after approximately 300 meters, turn left again, and then after 150 meters,
Welcome back to Amsterdam. As we start the second half, Ajax in the red and white shirts attacking the goal to our left. And now the pressure really is on them. They've got Zwamborn on, a defender, in place of Mertesteegen. And the pressure really on this home side now, because they seek these two goals. They've got to come even harder now for Nottingham Forest, always being aware of the fact that if they slip up just once at the back and Forest score, then with the away goal situation, then they have to get four. But at the moment they're breaking well here with Bonsing, crossing that in superbly as well. But in the end, it's Robertson right back there getting it away. And so it's a question now of Ajax pressurizing Forest as much as they can, with better finishing than they were able to show in the first half, but equally remaining absolutely tight at the back. It's not a comfortable situation for any side with just 45 minutes left. And Forest, I imagine, although it's not been spectacular, have been quite content with their first 45 minutes performance. Berber for Ajax. Back to Zwamborn. And now for Jensen. They've pushed a lot forward, Ajax, now. And Kroll is in a lot of space here. McGovern coming here to close him down a little bit. Schoenacker playing it wide again, this time for Bonsing. He is a winger. He is playing in the centre in the first half. Lerbe, nice skills there, looking to set up a shot. Nice skills again there, but the shot was terrible, and it's a goal kick for Nottingham Forest. And of course, Forest's ability in Europe has been to play so well away from home in second legs. They certainly did that in the last round in Dynamo Berlin, in East Berlin, when they went there a goal down. And of course, Forest have also shown their away ability a couple of times at Liverpool, when they went holding fairly slender leads and hung on well. And I suppose you could say if they can do it at Anfield, they can certainly do it here. But at the moment, it's Ajax coming for them again, off the face of Martin O'Neill. And Berbe with the throw for the Dutch champions. Rudy Kroll, number five, swinging that pass away to the right again to Laling. Bertels, who was hobbling pretty badly just before half time, but he's come out again. Robertson with the throw. Berbe, McGovern, Robertson, and this time it's a throw for Ajax. Lying very deep here, Rudy Kroll. What a lovely struck ball, though. A long, long way, and Shilton might have been in trouble there. And in fact, in the end, it's a throw for Ajax, which they want to take quickly with Bonsing. But what a beautifully struck ball that was from Rudy Kroll. Swanbourne, here's Kroll again. If anybody can set anything up for Ajax, it's him. It's Jensen with a shot, charged away by Kenny Burns. It's with Bertels. Surely that's a free kick. But not. Kroll playing it in again. An offside flag on the far side against Frank Arnesen. The referee spotted it, saw Forest in possession, told them to play on, and then has given a free kick for the foul on Martin O'Neill. Viv Anderson with it. Not a very good kick. Straight to Lerby. Bonsink still in play. And they rather let him go there. And he's found Lerby. Anderson's after him. And Lerby brought down there by Anderson. And a free kick to Ajax. Got the impression that Lerby fell there, but it's a free kick. It could be dangerous. Lining up behind it are Bonsing, Kroll inevitably. The wall there, 5 in it. Shilton's lined them up. Fonsink. Oh! Terrific piece of keeping there by Peter Shilton. As you can see there, curling nicely and Shilton down superbly. And a corner for Ajax. A deeper struck one there. Laling on the far side. Too high for him though. Forest throw. Ian Bowyer. Played forward there by Robertson. Off an Ajax player for another throw to Forest. John Robertson with it. Fair bit of obstruction going on there. That time it was an obstruction on Trevor Francis. Maybe a little bit of pulling at his shirt as well. A free kick again for Forrest. Bertels. Free kick again. Robertson. Frank Gray up there. Oh, he's turned a couple of them there, is Frank Gray. Bertels and Gray looking to try and find something here. Robertson with a nice little cross there. A little too high, though. And the claims for handball there, but the referee didn't want to know. But he's given a corner instead. Already taken. Now Gray with a chance to cross it in. Ajax weren't really ready for it. And my word, the header by Francis that looked as though it had to go in was wide of the Ajax goal. Really whipped in that cross there. Francis looked so well placed but didn't get a good connection. Now it's Kroll for Ajax. So a lot of good action at the start of this second half. And a bad pass there by Jensen. And the Ajax fans are getting a little restless. They know that time is beginning to run out on their team. And it's with Larry Lloyd again. A throw given to Forrest. It's a free kick. Frank Gray with it. Long left foot kick there. Trevor Francis getting free of his man. Tried to get the ball into the centre. And a goal kick. Carol Bonsink now for Ajax. To Rudy Kroll. Again, that beautifully struck ball there. Look, inch perfect, except that Arneson couldn't get possession of it. And in the end, it's Martin O'Neill who gets it away, but into touch. Arneson with the throw. And now it's with Kroll. Sweeping it to the far side there, but Robertson cut that one out. Ian Bowyer. Here's Laling for Ajax. Lerby. Chipped in there again. A flag is up for offside. Bertels having a battle there with Svanborn. Back it goes to Shrivers. Weinberg. Played forward again to Schenacker. Now Kroll. It was Francis who beat him there. Bowyer's who's up now for Nottingham Forest, but Weinberg is back. Berver. Zwanborn. Verva. Lerby. Verva. Lerby again. And Anderson for Nottingham Forest. Kroll. Francis getting the better of him there too. Good piece of aggressive play there by Trevor Francis. And a throw going to Ajax. Kroll battling back and now taking the throw. Zwanborn to Lalin. Ryzen banging on the far side. The ball must have just fractionally gone out of play there. Put there by Lalin. Forest throw. And a throw again. Forest crowd, I'm wondering if you can hear them. Their supporters are saying, come on, you yellows. It's been a good night for them so far. Frank Gray, onside. There's a chance here for Forest. And Bertels had a great chance there as Francis and Bertels between them. It was a two against one. And maybe Francis himself had a chance of taking it on for a shot. But certainly there was an opportunity there for Nottingham Forest, and if that one had been made to count, then this game would have been over. Forest pushing out a little more in this second half. That's partly because of the fact that Ajax themselves know they've got to push forward themselves even harder and be prepared to take a few risks in the back. Kroll now playing the ball wide again for Lalin. He's hit some really beautiful balls tonight, and that one's back to Shilton, but he couldn't stop it going out. It's a corner. Well, they've had two chances in this second half of Forest. The header by Francis, and Francis and Bertels between them, and now they face this corner. Kenny Burns up well. Bertels getting that one away, but there's not much support up there for Trevor Francis, but it's a throw to Nottingham Forest. Quickly taken. Francis again, surrounded by Ajax defenders. Oh, he's made a bit of space for himself. Burv is going across to challenge him as well. And no foul. So here come Ajax again with Lerby to Bonsink. Kroll. Jensen. And a good break by Arneson on the far side. Looking to cross the ball in there towards Schenacker. And a terrific piece of play there by John McGovern, because Lalin was in there in full flight, and little McGovern, he did so well. And here come Forrest now through Frankie Gray. The ball crossed in there towards Gary Bertels, but he couldn't quite get it, and Forrest are beginning to look more menacing on the break now. Looking for one goal that will settle everything, and getting a corner here already taken. John Robertson looking to get towards the byline. Weinberg is the barrier at the moment. Played back here again though for Boya. Oh, and Boya's lost out, and Schoenacker's stumbled. There was no foul there. O'Neill playing it back for safety all the way to Shilton. Coming up to a quarter of an hour of the second half gone.
Swanbourne very nearly headed that for Birtles. Instead it falls for Kroll. Burns playing it forward, but Francis couldn't connect. It's Lulling. Ajax coming forward once more. Too high for O'Neill. Bonsink playing it neatly inside for Lurvy, a man who's got quite a shot on him, but he's not within range yet. But here's Bonsink, he might get within range. Well, no, Jensen couldn't get it. Bowyer comfortably coming away with it, finding Robertson. Francis doing a lot of good running, running onto that far side, playing it nicely in here for Frankie Gray. That's a good run by him as well. He's got Birtles up there with him. Gary Birtles now. Gray. Robertson. Faced by Kroll. Now, can Robertson get to that byline and whip something over? No, he can't because he's outnumbered, but he's got a free kick. Kick taken. Robertson with it, that loping run of his. Larry Lloyd was in there with a header, but quite comfortably there for Pete Shrivers. And the throw out here for Bonsink. Lurvy, the Dane. For Arneson, another Dane. He's going past Viv Anderson. And he might get another chance of a shot, but Kenny Burns is there. And Burns has lost it to Arneson as well. Brought down right on the edge of the box as well. This could be a moment of danger for Nottingham Forest. The Romanian referee having no hesitation that that was a free kick. Now Kroll's up there, Arneson's in there, Lurby also. But Kroll might well try a little swinger. Lurby might try to hammer one, which he does, and Shilton down superbly. Well, the Dane holds his head because he wonders how Shilton ever got down as quickly as that. Through the wall, and Shilton wasn't very pleased with that, but he did very well. So still 0-0 inside the last half hour. Lurby, the man whose shot was saved by Peter Shilton. Kenny Burns tucking it away for a throw to Ajax. Big Frank Arneson, the number 8. Another free kick for Ajax for the foul by Anderson on Bonsink. Arneson will take it. The pressure beginning to grow again on Nottingham Forest. Curled in towards the near post. And it went a long way. They claim for a handball, but they haven't got it. They claim a penalty, but the Romanian referee doesn't want to know. That's it coming in there. That's where they claim was handball. But the referee has denied them a penalty. Arneson now for Ajax. And a nicely timed little challenge there by John McGovern. Just saw enough of the ball to nick in there and put it behind for the corner. I say it looked touch and go about that penalty, but the referee had no doubts, and there was no doubt about that header from Kenny Burns either. Forrest getting it away again. Francis there making a terrific run. And a very unlucky indeed for the ball not to go his way. Verver instead. But this a go for Robertson. And now as both sides really commit themselves to attack even more. Forrest on the breakaway. And Ajax through sustained pressure. There's a lot of football left in this cup tie. Oh, my word. And if Jensen could have just connected with that, that could have been very, very difficult and embarrassing for Nottingham Forest. Or rather, Schoenacker. Twenty-5 minutes left. Kroll to Bonsink. And the Ajax crowd are beginning to find their voices again now, as Arnesen crosses it in again, and it's behind for the corner. And we've now reached a period where Forrest have really got to make sure their nerve holds, as another corner comes in, knocked away that time by Frankie Gray, and that time by Larry Lloyd. Weinberg, Lalling for Ajax, crossed in once more, Lloyd is right up there, but it's headed behind that time by Schoenacker, and it must have come off Lloyd's head, because Ajax have a corner, and now the pressure is really on Forrest, whacking another corner in there, and it's into the net! It's Lerby! There's the corner going in, and at the far post, it's the ducking header of Søren Lerby into the Forrest net, and Ajax are really in this game now. So now we'll see what Forrest can do with 25 minutes left. Lerby the scorer. And Forrest might well regret the chances, the couple of chances that have come their way in this second half, which have been missed. Because Ajax are going to be at their throats now, you can be sure of that. It's Arnesen on the far side. They've never lost a European Cup tie here since 1969. And they are aiming to get at least another goal now to take this one into extra time. Kroll. And the noise is absolutely deafening now. McGovern. But Forrest have been through this sort of thing before, and they know what's expected of them. But they've had to take so much pressure. I think much more than they thought. I think they really felt that they could come here and have a go at Ajax. But it certainly hasn't been that way. Berver. Lerby the scorer. And there's a lot of space here as Jensen takes it up. Arnesen. Forrest are in a lot of trouble at the moment, and this time it's behind off O'Neill for the corner. Suddenly their hopes are sky high here in Amsterdam, as Boya gets a free kick. And this is what Forrest need at the moment, just a few moments to collect themselves and to remember what they have to do. Shilton away. Bertels getting up well. Francis is in the middle. Boya's coming up quickly. It's a throw to Nottingham Forest. Right, can Forrest hang on? McGovern. For McGovern again. Francis waiting in the middle, but it won't get to him. Kroll cut that one out. And there's the Ajax manager, Leo Beenhakker. They say his future's very much in doubt here. In fact, they've already been saying that you can see what he wants. He wants men to go forward. One of the youngest managers in Dutch football. He's only 37. And they've been saying here he's on the verge of getting the sack. Well, if Ajax can get a second goal or even a third, then I would think that's not possible. It's with Kroll at the moment. Everybody except Shrivers now in the Forest half of the field. The yellow shirts have really come back in defence in depth as the ball is crossed in again. Larry Lloyd getting that one away for Forrest. Francis beaten in the air by Kroll. Arnesen for Ajax. Kroll right up there. That's where Forrest don't want him to get, where he's really most dangerous. Bonsink with a little cross coming in. And it was Boya who hacked that away, not very far. Weinberg, Lalling.
Weinberg again. Jensen playing it in again. Once again it's Weinberg on the far side. And a goal kick. 20 minutes left. Bertels battling, and he caught something on the left knee there from Berver. A free kick to Nottingham Forest. Well, the next 20 minutes will tell them whether they can find a place in the European Cup final in Madrid, whether they've got the courage and the character enough to withstand the pressure that's going to be put on them now by these Dutch champions. Swenborn to Kroll. Berver playing it forward to Lalling. Lloyd tucking it away again. Weinberg. Arneson on that far side. Swanborn. Look at Kroll again, wanting a bit more of the action. Sweeping that ball across to Lurby. And they found him unmarked there. Lloyd didn't get the header he wanted in there. And Kenny Burns bravely getting in there as Ajax were coming in for another shot. And at the moment, Forrest are beginning to look a little shaky. Lalling. Swanborn. Here's that man Kroll again. Lovely pass there for Schoenacker. Forrest trying to force them back again, bringing their back men up way outside the penalty area. Arneson very deep. The long ball forward again. Anderson ducking underneath it, keeping his cool. Francis now for O'Neill. Played on and offside there for Bertels. There wasn't much in it. He could almost have been inside his own half, I thought, when the ball was played. But in fairness, the linesman was perfectly placed. So it's Rudy Kroll with the kick for Ajax. Jensen. McGovern trying to stop him but not succeeding. And Lalling on the far side, played it again there. And a terrific saving tackle again by Kenny Burns when it looked as though Jensen might get in there for a shot on goal. But Forrest are really up against it now. One down, leading 2-1 on aggregate still. But here's Kroll. Almost all the play in this second half has been confined into that third of the field around that Forrest goal. Arneson crossing the ball in once more towards Lurby, who got up well once more. And on the far side, it's Forrest trying to get themselves out of trouble. Back with Shilton. Bertels. Bonsink. Swanborn. Or rather, Berver, now Swanborn. Robertson trying to hold off his man. And that should be Peter Shilton's ball. Right underneath that crossbar, there was nothing to spare. Forrest pushing up there, as you could see in that picture. They want to keep people away from that penalty area as much as they can. Bertels beaten in the air by Swanborn, but a bit of space here for Martin O'Neill. But they've really achieved nothing coming forward, just those two chances in this second half, Forrest. And it's Henning Jensen now for Ajax. Another throw for Ajax. We're coming to the last quarter of an hour of the game. Oh, and Larry Lloyd has lost out on that one, but
The crowd are howling for a penalty, but that was never on. And that's off the referee, which is bad luck for Forrest. And a linesman flagging on the far side for an offside against La Ling. And so it's a free kick for Nottingham Forest, who now have 15 minutes with the number 8 Arnesen down there injured. 15 minutes to hold out. Well, they've brought on one substitute at half-time. Here's the slow motion again. There was never a penalty. And that's how Arnesen was injured. Well, Arneson's limping on. Svanborn, a little header there for Berver. Weinberg. Lalling. Svanborn, and away come those red and white shirts of Ajax again. And that's too firm. They might be getting a little desperate as well, because they know that they've got to achieve so much in the 13 minutes or so that remain. So although we say it's Forest have got to stay cool, which they have, then Ajax have got to play patiently and coolly as well, and take everything that's coming their way. It's a free kick for the foul on Gary Birtles by Svanborn. Kenny Burns with the kick. Taking his time, wanting to cool things down a bit. Here's Anderson. That's a throw. Francis and Burvey. Lerby, stopped by McGovern, Kroll right in there, and O'Neill getting in there. No free kick given, and McGovern playing it a long way back to Peter Shilton. Well, I don't know what I was thinking of doing then, ducking into the ball when it's in the keeper's hands. It's a throw to Ajax. Well, what they've lacked up front tonight, Forrest, have got to more than make up for with what they can produce at the back now, with 12 minutes to go. Forrest leading 2-1 on aggregate, but one down on the night. Roll with a throw. O'Neill. Well, the ball finally going out of play for another Ajax throw. And Forrest do seem so out of sorts up front that they must be desperate to hold on and not concede another goal, because if it goes to extra time, you can't really see how Forrest at their present form, the way they're playing at the moment, will produce a goal, and then who knows, we could be on our way towards those nerve-wracking penalties if the scores are level at the end of extra time. As it is, Forrest are leading 2-1 on aggregate as Larry Lloyd plays it back carefully once more to Peter Shilton. Francis looking for that little bit of pace, but he was never the favourite for that ball. Anderson cutting that one out and putting it away, but the linesman in fact was flagging for an offside against Lerby. 10 minutes left. Kenny Burns with the free kick.
Kroll's header, and won by McGovern. Svanborn getting it away. McGovern again, the short little pass for Bertels. O'Neill playing it forward again. Here's Berver in for Pete Shrivers. Svanborn. That wasn't a very clever ball for Ajax. It's a throw to Nottingham Forest. And launch a long throw there towards Trevor Francis. It's another throw for Nottingham Forest. Time must be hanging heavy for the Forest supporters now. In fact, also with the Ajax supporters, it must be galloping away, and they've all seem to have got a feeling of the tension of this moment. The stadium is pretty quiet. It's as both sets of supporters wonder what on earth's going to happen in the 9 minutes that are left. It's a free kick at the moment, though, for Nottingham Forest, and that brings a few howls of anguish from the Dutchman. Frank Gray will take the kick. Oh yeah, right up there. Schoenacker is the one doing the shadowing. And the ball just off the corner flag, in fact. But eventually going out for a throw to Ajax. And that's a throw to Forrest. Well, have they weathered that little crisis? They've got the ball, they've worked it up into this half of the field now, and they've quietened the crowd a little bit, taking that ball towards the corner flag, but there's a long, long time to go yet before you try any tricks like that. And the ball back with Shrivers, who will want to get this forward now quickly for Ajax. Lerb has gone right forward now. It's with Henning Jensen for Ajax, the number seven. Svanborn, here's Kroll running into that action again. But John Robertson getting there first. But it's a throw just inside their own half now for Ajax. Played here for Berber. Inside again for Jensen. Flicked in there, it went a long way before Bowyer, I think it was, who got the boot to that one. Kroll, an offside again. And certainly the Forest fans must sigh with relief when they see Ajax coming forward, and up goes the linesman's flag, and it's a little bit of a breather again for their team. About six, just over 6 minutes left. Frank Gray, a mighty free kick, well inside the Ajax half. But here come Ajax again. Kroll playing it wide once more for Lalling. And a header! Well saved by Shilton from Jensen. And there was an amazing amount of gap on that far side, as you can see now. A long cross coming in there. Look at the space for Jensen coming in, but straight at Peter Shilton. It's a throw to Forrest. We have 5 minutes left, and Forrest at this moment just 5 minutes away from a second successive appearance in the European Cup final. With all that that means for themselves in terms of finance and in terms of their supporters,
just 5 minutes if they can hold out these last onslaughts from the Dutch champions Ajax, and particularly from the man on the ball at the moment, Rudy Krol. Again, they've pulled everybody. They've just got those two front men, Bertels and Francis, up. But you can see Francis coming back there, trying to get hold of Krol. But Krol weaving his way through there, finding Lalling. Here comes the cross again in once more towards Jensen. And quite comfortably there for Peter Shilton. They're getting in a few crosses, our Ajax. And once or twice, Forrest have looked a bit vulnerable against them. Bertels, Lerby shrugging off the challenge of Gary Bertels, the man who scored the goal that's made things really on a knife edge now for Nottingham Forest. Anderson getting that one away. Four minutes left, and here's Jensen. The yellow shirts of Forest are all back in strength now. They might need to be. That's too high, that one from Arneson. And that'll be a goal kick. So, Peter Shilton. Beaten once tonight. If he gets beaten again, we should go into extra time. But they've certainly looked a much more formidable proposition in this second leg of Ajax than they did up at the City Ground in the first leg. Helped on by a really hostile crowd. Francis, well, he's got away from Berber this time, but the whistle had gone, presumably for a foul by Francis. So here come Ajax again. Inside the last 3 minutes now. Rudy Krol sweeping out a long pass there, but that's far too hard for Bonsink, and played there by Anderson. Back to Peter Shilton. A long kick forward once more. Krol with the backward header, knowing that it'll come through to Pete Shrivers. Massive kick from Shrivers, 14 and a half stone of him. Up goes Larry Lloyd. Weinberg to Lalling. Now Lerby, the man who scored the goal for Ajax tonight. Looks as though he wants to get into a shooting position again. And indeed, he let one pop there, but it was always wide of Shilton's goal. We have 2 minutes left on the clock. Nottingham Forest 2 minutes away, and the Ajax trainer, manager, Leo Beenhakker, knows it too, in the leather coat there on the left. Certainly his side have had so much of the play, they've been able to create so little against a really solid Nottingham Forest defence, by and large. And now here's Bertels. And a foul there on Krol by Martin O'Neill. We have a minute and a quarter left for Forest to defend this lead that now has been made just a one-goal lead. 2-0 on the first leg. One goal down on this leg, 2-1 Forest lead on aggregate, with exactly 1 minute remaining now. Weinberg, and somehow Forest have got to keep them out. That's a goal kick, that'll take up a few more seconds. The referee's had a look at his watch, but I think it's a bit too optimistic to expect that it'll be blown for at least another minute. But Forest have got to hang on now. They've taken so much from Ajax tonight, and they've conceded just that one goal. It's really all hands to the pump now, as Bonsink twists and turns. Larry Lloyd gets up there again. Kenny Burns looking to get a touch of the action, gets that header in there well, and McGovern playing it wide for Gary Bertels. And Bertels now going past his man, the first time he's been able to get past Kroll tonight. Supported by Anderson. And an offside against Bertels. And I hope Anderson gets back quickly, because Forrest want him back there now. We're playing time added on for injuries, and it's over. And Forrest are through to the European Cup final. Winners by 2-1 on aggregate. Having won 2-0 in the first leg and conceded that solitary goal by Lerby here tonight. But they've hung on, and the team are going across to where their fans are jubilant up in the crowd. You can see them going away to the right there. And Ajax have been defeated. Not the great old Ajax of old, but a side that had so much of the game and called for a lot of character and courage indeed from Nottingham Forest in their defence tonight. The defeated trainer, and it's Brian Clough and Peter Taylor together who are the winners again. Complaints there from the players as they come off about something, but there's the beaten side, and the victorious team are Nottingham Forest, who get another English side through to the European Cup final to be played in Madrid on May the 28th. A good, solid achievement by Nottingham Forest. Not a spectacular game, and not one you'll remember for a long time. But now they have every chance, these men in yellow, to turn it on in Madrid on May the 28th. Well done, Nottingham Forest. A final scoreline here then. Ajax 1, Nottingham Forest 0. But on aggregate, 2-1 to Nottingham Forest. At which point, we take a short break.
Just a second, Mike. I'll put Brian on again. I'm listening out. Just a second. Mike Ward,
please. Hello, Michael. Was it all right? Yes, they were coming through okay in the second half.
Good.
Bless your old heart. That was much appreciated. Lovely. All right. I'll tell him. Okay. All right, my friend, it'll be about a quarter of an hour. Yeah, and you too.
He wouldn't come. You knew that, did you?
He wouldn't come.
No, so he sent me.
What's his game?
Did you know he wasn't coming?
No.
Right.
My friend, it's always good to see you.
Yes. Hey, I'll not leave you in alerts, you know
Arsenal,
that.
Arsenal scored in the last 2 minutes.
Truly? They've won?
Well, I don't know. It's
Kevin
Hughes
in London. Just tell them Brian.
What's his problem?
Yeah.
Is he got a problem? Got a problem or what?
No, no, he just... It'll be in the press, obviously.
Right, thank you. Let's keep going. Right, they're going and you can scan.
Okay,
Brian.
We'll go
ahead in 5 seconds.
We'll
give
you what? 3.5 minutes?
Yeah, sure.
May
not need
come
all
in
that.
2 minutes now.
Yeah, sure, sure.
Okay. Okay, Peter?
Yeah.
Right, off we go then.
Okay. Congratulations, Peter. That was another marvellous performance by Nottingham Forest. What was your reaction to it, though, first of all?
Well, we didn't come to defend, as I told you beforehand. We were made to defend, and I thought we defended magnificently. Delighted with it. We defended as well as I've seen us defend all season.
You defended because you had to.
Okay,
yes, I mean, no choice. They had the crowd behind them, they attacked us from the start. We were determined at half-time to go out then, but they pressed us back. And overall, it was a superb defensive display.
Peter Shilton made a couple of very important saves.
Yeah, I thought we could have gone in front, actually, before that. I thought we had the best chance of the match. I thought Trevor should have put us in front with the header from across from, I think it was Frankie Gray. But we were destined after 20 minutes, in my opinion, and shortly after half-time as well. We knew we had to defend the 2-0 lead. And we wanted to attack them, as I've said, but we had no choice, and I thought we did it well.
Yes. And then they scored that goal in the second half. That must have been a very edgy last 20 minutes or so for you.
Yes, it was. We had a sticky spell of about 15 minutes during that period, building up to the goal and afterwards. Marking was bad once it went through everybody, but we weathered it, and I think we were the finalists again.
Who were the defenders who particularly showed themselves for you tonight?
All the back four, particularly Burns. I don't want to dismiss it. It was a team effort of the highest order. I thought possibly up front we could have relieve them with a bit more positive running, probably Trevor. But midfield, Ian Bowyer did all that was asked of him. But the back four, in particular, did magnificently. They never got through to Shorten, really.
Made just a couple of saves, didn't he?
Yes. Considering the pressure they had, Peter wasn't overworked due to the back four.
And now you're through to another European Cup final. What does that mean to the club? It means an awful lot, of course.
Financially, it's a real boost for the club, you know, with having the new stand. But from our own point of view, the players, prestige-wise, we're delighted. But tell me it's Hamburg.
Yeah. That's right.
Yeah, well, let's go there and produce a better final than what we produced last year.
Yes. And that means Kevin Keegan.
Well, yes, I'm looking forward to meeting him. Very much so. I think Burnsy is, and Lloyd is.
Why do you say that?
I do. I just think he's... I like the guy. He has a lot to say. The chips will be down in May. I'm looking forward to seeing Kevin.
It's probably better for Forrest to go there and face Hamburg rather than Real Madrid in front of their own crowd.
I would think so. Plus the fact, you know, we've got a better reading of German football and probably the Spanish. Of the two, I would have picked Hamburg. I think it could be a great final.
You've shown yourself to be a complete side in many ways tonight, the way you've defended. People know how well you can attack.
Yeah, I get a lot of pleasure out of sides that can defend. You know, it takes me back to our Derby days when we could really defend. We don't achieve that standard here, but we came very close to it tonight. And we should have hit them on the break, and we should have won this match tonight. But the object was getting through on two legs, and I'm delighted. But defensively, we were superb tonight at times.
Good. Peter, congratulations. Look forward to seeing you in Madrid now. Thanks a lot.
What are we rushing it again?
No problem. What's that? No.
It's
alright. That's lovely.
Right. Let us know when you're happy with that, please.
Just a quick spot check, sir.
Spot check that unilateral please, and let us know if you're happy.
I tell you, it gave me such a stomachache.
Oh,
no,
spot check that unilateral please, and let us know if you're happy. Thank you.
It's quick to the car.
Yeah.
Did you? Do you get it on those? Do you?
Tonight.
Our director is asking for. Are there any more interviews?
No.
We're just getting a clear from London. Tape. Just checking the tape from London.
Yeah.
How long was it going? They score.
Take a two shot.
Take a
two
shot.
Not two shots.
Wait a minute.
Just chat for two.
Brian, looking for you.
Yes, so I'm now asking you a really penetrating question, Pete, and I've really foxed you because you don't quite know how to answer it, but
I'll answer it. Just
yes. Thanks a million instantly for coming out and doing that a little bit before the start. That was, that gave us a lovely little opportunity.
I thought he was out of order.
Thank you very much.
Oh, no doubt he was.
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
I've no doubt he was.
Anything else?
But you'll find those everywhere you go. Little blokes, and this is his big night, you know?
Yeah, but we looked after him in Nottingham.
Yeah. You see?
All right, thank you very much.
Your day will come again.
Oh, yes.